published 2,243 est, the 28th of November 2017 updated 0133 est, the 29th of November 2017 U.S. President Donald Trump looks at the empty chair of top Senate Democrat Chuck Schumer, who along with House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi snubbed a planned meeting at the White House. U.S. President Donald Trump clashed with Democratic leaders in dramatic fashion Tuesday, heaping pressure on Congress to craft a compromise on federal spending or face a crippling government shutdown in 10 days. Hours after the president suggested a funding deal with Democrats may be impossible, House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi and top Senate Democrat Chuck Schumer pulled out of a planned White House meeting with Trump that they said would be fruitless. Given that the president doesn't see a deal between Democrats and the White House, we believe the best path forward is to continue negotiating with our Republican counterparts in Congress instead, the PER said in a statement. Trump shot back that he was not surprised the Democrats rejected his offer, saying they were very far apart on several issues like immigration. They've been all talk and they've been no action. And now it's even worse, now it's not even talk, Trump declared during the meeting, which went ahead with Republican congressional leaders an empty chair on either side of the president, underscoring the absence of their Democratic counterparts. Later, after a new North Korean missile launch, Trump said on Twitter, "It's more important than ever to fund our GOVT military. Dems should NT hold troop funding hostage for amnesty illegal immigration. I ran on stopping illegal immigration and won big. They can't now threaten a shutdown to get their demands." The rare public rejection of White House talks ratcheted up tensions in Washington over a 2018 spending bill that must pass by a December 8th deadline, and served as a stinging rebuke to a president who often mocks his rivals on Twitter. The spat heaps pressure on Congress to craft a compromise or face a crippling government shutdown next month. And it muddied the waters on the same day Trump headed to Congress to urge fellow Republicans to unite behind his tax overhaul, a controversial bill that he wants on his desk by year-end. Trump lunched with Senate Republicans for an hour, answering questions from Ron Johnson and Susan Collins, who have concerns about the bill. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, addressing reporters afterwards, acknowledged the challenge in getting at least 50 of his chamber's 52 Republicans on board, likening it to solving a Rubik's Cube. Chuck and Nancy. Senate Democratic Leader Chuck Schumer and House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi said talks with fellow Republicans on Capitol Hill would be more useful than a meeting with President Donald Trump. Behind the tough talk, Trump needs Schumer and Pelosi to rally their party's votes to keep government running through the next 10 months. But the self-styled master dealmaker Trump derailed Tuesday's plans for a bipartisan White House meeting on the challenge ahead when he hit the two top Democrats whom he called Chuck and Nancy in a morning tweet. "Problem is they want illegal immigrants flooding into our country unchecked, are weak on crime and want to substantially raise taxes," he added. "I don't see a deal," Schumer later said. Democrats would meet with Trump anytime, anywhere, any place, so long as he was serious about a deal. "But there is an alternative when the president stays out of it. We seem to do much better." The White House expressed disappointment at the no-show, urging Democrats to put aside their pettiness and grandstanding, and saying Trump's invitation remained open. High price McConnell did not hide his irritation at the snub, calling it a lack of seriousness about the prospect of a looming government shutdown. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell blasted the antics of the Democratic leaders in Congress in 2013. A similar spending feud caused 850,000 government officials to be sent home temporarily, and as much as half a percentage point was shaved off economic growth. Trump has staked much of his fragile political reputation on being a good steward of the economy, so failure could be damaging. But Democrats are demanding a steep price for their support. They say funding for Trump's border wall must be stripped out, and Trump must honor the Obama administration's pledge to allow migrants brought to the country as children to remain. The issue, as tricky as it is not the only problem on Trump's plate. Tough sledding in December, a debt ceiling deadline is also looming. If missed, the U.S. government could be hurtling towards a technical default in the new year. And beyond the spending fight, Trump's primary task will be to pass tax cuts, which Republicans see as absolutely vital to keep voters and donors happy. Having so far failed to pass healthcare, immigration or infrastructure reforms, Trump faces a party revolt if he cannot make tax cuts law. With the party controlling the White House and both chambers of Congress, the task should be straightforward. But little is straightforward in Washington these days. The administration has struggled to convince the public that the tax cut will help middle-class families, and a Harvard-Harris poll showed a majority of voters oppose the bill. Democrats portray the proposals as good for big business but bad for ordinary Americans, while half a dozen Republican senators have publicly expressed doubts about the plan, which the nonpartisan Congressional Budget Office projects would increase the national debt by $1.4 trillion by 2027. The White House argues the cuts will boost growth, in turn increasing tax revenue, although most economists disagree. Sorry, we are not currently accepting comments on this article.